right. Now that we've jumped back in, we're looking at this idea of the principles of money. And so this is going to take up that that second portion out of this idea of looking at money systems. The first thing we're going to look at is money and banking. The United States, over the years, we've changed how bankings work, because when they started, they did things to try to start the banking system, had some failures and things, but they worked it out. And so we're going to look at a timeline here in the next few minutes. So the first thing is in 1775, during the American Revolution, the Continental Congress needed to figure out a way to pay for the services of the war. And so what they did was they issued their first paper money. And when they issued that money, it was called a Continental. And with the Continental, it didn't have a great amount of value because there wasn't a whole lot to back it up. And so because it didn't have great value, this phrase down at the bottom you see here, it's not worth a Continental, came to mean that it was a useless piece of paper. And so if you're looking at that plan, you're going to see under, or you're looking at the sheet that I gave you, the timeline, you're going to see 1775, look down there for Continental Congress, paper currency, and that's going to be the answer. You're going to pull that one up. In 1791, Congress decided to establish its first bank, and that was established in Philadelphia, and that was to also try to organize and get this financing for the war. Now, it only had a 20-year charter, so in those 20 years in 1811, it disbanded. They had some problems. There were people who were uncomfortable with this idea of a central bank. However, that was formed there in 1791. In 1816, after that first bank failed, the Congress started and chartered a second bank in the United States. And it too had a 20-year charter, and so that charter expired in 1836, and it was not renewed. So they tried to do it one more time to see if that would work. So since it didn't, in 1836 through 1865, they had what was called the free banking era. So there was no organized national banking system. In terms of organized banking or regulated banking of any kind. And so the states began to charter some banks. And when they started that, and then the banks started issuing their own bank notes. And so every bank may have their own notes, every state had their own. It became a real problem. And so for these from 36 to 65, it was real difficult. That meant there were 10,000 different kinds of bank notes. There were all kinds of banks that were closing and counterfeiting. And so it was a big problem and that the government needed to do something about that. So in 1863, the government stepped in. Congress passed the National Currency Act. So, and that was to kind of establish some kind of monitoring of the U.S. economy, and so that's what that act started. Now, in 1984, we have President Lincoln signing this revision of the law, starting the National Banking Act. They had a comptroller, and this comptroller is one who's over all of it, and so the comptroller becomes the one who's responsible for currency. And so they started doing banknotes and in a more organized system there in 1863. In 1863, here we have the banknotes that are brought in, and those banknotes were the mainstay or the main money source of monies in the United States until 1914. So in 1879, they realized they had to back up what they had with something of value. So what they did was the U.S. adopted a gold standard. And what that meant was that there was gold backing up what the paper money was valued at. So that's what this that's what the slide there talks about. It's defining the value of that money. Now, in the 1900s, Congress finally passed the Gold Standard Act, and that made it official that the dollar that there was a gold dollar. And so you could have a gold dollar piece, and that gold dollar was being backed by the US, and it had a very definite value to it. And so that became kind of the trade also. So you could carry your own gold with you in terms of a dollar coin. In 1913, the Federal Reserve Act was passed, and it was passed to form a bank, a banking system, and centralized banks that would help with the leveling out of money. And they'd already had some problems in 1893 and 1907 with some financial scares. And so they set up a federal bank system, of which Dallas has one of those 12 banks that issues currency that is officially can print currency for the United States and monitors areas of the country financially. And then as a whole, that Federal Reserve system works to support all that. So that's the Federal Reserve Bank. Is, like I said, it's the central 12 regions you see there: Boston, New York, Philadelphia, Cleveland, Richmond, Atlanta, Chicago, St. Louis, Minneapolis, Kansas City, Dallas, and San Francisco are going to be those. And then the last slide we're going to look at is that they're all considered independent because they do make their decisions for what's going on in the region. However, they do work inside of congressional oversight, and they work together through that Board of Governors. All right, that's the notes that you need to complete the assignment sheet with the timeline on it, and these are the notes you needed to take the quiz, which is there in Canvas also. All right. That being said, now it's time to go out and finish these notes and take that quiz. Thanks. Have a great day.